Watson takes a snap, rolls right, looks into the end zone. Hunter Renfro caught it! Touchdown! 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 With a second left, Watson hits Renfro, and Clemson grabs a 34.
Walk-ons, walk-ons, what's going on? It's Sam Stillwater, walk-on coach, and I have five words of wisdom or five words of advice. I think I like wisdom better because I've been through it. I've been through the down of downs in the walk-on experience, and that's why I'm here to share it with you so you can prepare yourself mentally and physically to encounter those obstacles and overcome. And it's like when those obstacles come, I already told you about it. You already know. So it's like, I got to get through this instead of being shocked like I was as a walk-on and learn those realities the hard way. See, you get to know these realities and prepare for them up front so you have an advantage. And that's what this channel is about. Now, with that being said, if you are an athlete, and especially if you are a walk-on athlete, go ahead and subscribe to the channel and like it if you don't mind. And then I'm also leaving the link to a website. I don't know who started it. I don't know. But it's called thewalkoncoach.com, where you can sign up. You put in your name and your email so we can stay locked in regardless. And you'll get access to free information such as your free PDF of the realities of being a walk-on. And this is going to help you understand the obstacles that could possibly come so you can prepare for it. So when they come, it's just like, you know, you already know, you already prepared for it. So you're not hurt. You're not bothered. You just overcome. And that's important for your experience as a walk-on. Now, let's get into these five words of wisdom that come from my experience as a walk-on, and I'm pretty sure, just like most of my videos, if you look in the comments, that everybody who has been a walk-on athlete, whether they, you know, didn't play or they reached their goals and beyond that, they typically agree with what I'm saying. And if you haven't watched the video, The Realities of a Walk-On, that was the first video that really got this channel started and has been helping walk-ons around the world. So I want to introduce you to the acronym, E.P.R.O.S. So remember this acronym, and the next time you see a walk-on, just look at them and say, E.P.R.O.S. And they're gonna be like, huh? And that's when you send them to this channel, tell them to subscribe and learn about E.P.R.O.S. because you need to know about E.P.R.O.S. to be able to succeed in this walk-on experience. E.P.R.O.S. Let's start with the E. E is for endurance. You're going to need endurance for this experience. Trust me. Do not go into the experience thinking, oh, this is, you know, as soon as I step on, as soon as I walk on, you know, I'm getting my reward. I'm stepping on the field. Please don't go in expecting that. Go in expecting that you're going to have to endure, basically. It may be a couple of years, 1 to 2 years before you actually get a reward, because as a walk-on, you have to work your way up. And the amount of time that takes, it varies. And all I'm telling you is be ready mentally to endure. E.P.R.O.S. P is for persistence, because you're going to have to persistently and consistently show up, show out, stand out for you to eventually get your reward. When it's 95 degrees and it's camp and you've been working hard every single day and it's day 10 of camp, the whole team is sore, you're tired, y'all can barely run, this is your opportunity. And the only way you can take advantage of that opportunity is if you are persistently showing up and showing out. You can't take the day off like everybody else. You can't take a sprint off, because when everybody else is taking a sprint off, that's your opportunity. And that's your, a lot of times, that's your only opportunity. So, persistent. E.P.R.O.S. R is for resilience. How many times can you bounce back from huge disappointment? How many times can you put in all that you have, put your all into practice all week? Then you get to the game, and the coach has already said several times, you know, I might have a spot for you on special teams. I might have a spot for you on defense. If we get up by 25, you know, I can put you in the game. Let's say they said something like that. And it's game time, and those things happen to where you're like, oh, my time is coming. And it doesn't happen. Your time doesn't come that game. Can you bounce back from that? It's hard. I'm telling you, I went through it over and over and over again. So my question for you is, how many times can you bounce back from that? Are you ready for that? If not, you gotta get ready. You'll have to prepare yourself for that. And like I said, it'll be another obstacle where you're prepared to play, but when this disappointment happens, you're like, ah, Sam Stitwood, a walking coach, told me about that. So when that happens and you hit that huge disappointment, guess what? Next week, start all over again. You gotta put your all into it all over again. E.P.R.O.S. O is for overachieve. Overachieving is a habit you're going to have to create. You're going to have to always do more than everybody else. You're going to always have to do extra, because by doing the same thing everybody else is doing, you just, I mean, you're invisible, basically, especially as a walk-on. You're going to have to do extra every single day. When the team is lifting weights, stay back, do another set, do a couple more reps. You may not think anybody's watching, but people do watch, and they are inspired by that, whether it's a coach or your teammates. That's a habit, and that's a beautiful habit to have, because you don't know what can come of that. In practice, find a way to do extra. If you need to work on your power running, run through the dummies after practice. If you need to work on your footwork, do two or three drills, an extra 5-10 minutes after practice. I promise you, eventually somebody notices, and this is a strategy to eventually get your reward, because you're standing out. And the last letter of E.P.R.O.S. is self-motivation, because you have to have fuel. Fuel has to come from somewhere for you to endure, persist, have resilience, and overachieve. If you can't motivate yourself, none of that is gonna happen. So where is your fuel coming from? Can you work hard this week, every day this week, be disappointed, never get a reward, and do it again the next week, and the next week, and the next week? How many times can you do it? I struggled. I did it so many times, and I have to give myself credit for that. I did it over 30, 40 games. I mean, I was able to remotivate myself over and over, and I want you to go even further than I did. So self-motivation is key. Self-motivation is really probably the most important one. And that's important throughout life, because, I mean, disappointments come all the time, whether you're playing football, another sport, entrepreneurship, working a 9-to-5. Things are gonna come where you're gonna have to be able to remotivate yourself. So those are 5 words of wisdom for walk-ons. Remember the acronym E.P.R.O.S. capital E-P-R-O-S. Drop it in the comments. And I appreciate y'all watching. Don't forget, y'all can also find me on Instagram at tobegreat. That's T-O-B-E underscore great. Y'all take this information. Oh, don't forget to subscribe. And don't forget to click the link in the description to visit thewalkoncoach.com to sign up to receive even more free insider information. Y'all take this information and y'all be great.